Further ado, Broadway has been making fun of itself for years, but never to such hysterical effect as in a song from Something Rotten called A Musical. So here's the Shorecrest Upper School dance troupe and singing troupe with A Musical. Give them a big hand.
How our musical? It appears to be a play, but the dialogue stops. And the plots convey their song
with it. So an actor's there, saying his lines, and then out of nowhere he just starts singing?
Yes!
That is the stupidest thing that I have ever heard. You're gonna play on someone's stage, so you sing it? It's absurd! What girl is going to sit there while an actor breaks into song? What the possible thought could the audience think? Other than this is horribly wrong.
Remarkably, they won't sing it.
Why not?
Because
it's a musical. A musical. And nothing doesn't make me as a musical. And a shed no face, so the music's quietly musical. Some make you happy, some make you sad. Some not quite big, some quite small. Some are too long, some are just plays with song. Some musicals have no talking at all.
Talking at all?
That's right, there's no talking. All the dialogue is sung. Never heard a re-dramatic version! And they often stay on the note for a very long time, so that when you change to a different note, you notice.
Miserable!
I believe it's pronounced miserable.
And people actually like this?
No, they love it! And what's not to love? In such a life, there's nothing quite like a musical. Oh, another Christian, and I've been the tone of the best part yet. You've got fascinated with the move into your feet.
It's a musical!
do, those who can't teach. It's not true here, Shorecrest. I, for one, still play in sleazy bars, and I teach the children. This gentleman here is not only a playwriting teacher, but he has a play running right now in Tampa called Moneymaker at the Heather's Theater. And I took a shower.
Okay.
Is it sold out anymore?
Tonight might be.
Are microphones on?
Hello?
Yeah.
Can you hear me now?
So anyway, go see this play. It's a little bit on the R-rated side, just so you know, don't take your young children's, or they'll get a real education real early. But now we're gonna head back in time do a song from our childhood by Simon Garfunkel.
Unfortunately, the light brown frizz wig and desert boots I ordered did not arrive in time, so you will have to imagine Garfunkel.
Close your eyes, we're going to sound just like them. Not really.
I'm just a poor boy, though my story's seldom told. I've squandered my resistance for a pocket full of mumbles, such are promises. All lies and jests, till the man hears what he wants to hear and disregards the rest. When I left my home and my family, I was no more than a boy in the company of strangers, in the quiet of the railway stations, running scared, laying low, seeking out the foreign borders where the ragged people go, looking for the places only they would know.
Please welcome, they want to be known as B-, so we're going to interview. Not a very high bar. Please welcome B minus. Give a big welcome.
Thank you. what if that diva has to run an opera company? Every small detail to smooth their bones, every pretty face to scrutinize. I plan this opera company. Why take on this artist chore? Sleepless nights I pace across my bedroom floor. Why do I live completely for this opera company? 'Cause it's mine, from the stall to the porch, from the walls, from the balconies and lotus far and near. It belongs all to me, every item that you see, from the cellar to the crystal chandelier, from the fluted marble grandstand to the elevated promenade, from every toilet bowl to every leading goal. This place is mine. I will sing, I will blow, I will never let it go, I will hold it ever captive in my hand. Like a god, like a queen, I will enter any scene and control it like a kingdom I command. And I pity any baritone who attempts to tread the stage I am. With no polite request, he is here at my behest. Because it's all mine, my curtain.
Don't worry,
are a mess. My bag's getting wet, and so is my dress.
I love the rain, how everything
the
shimmers.
The wind's picking up, we've got no umbrella.
Dogs are there like morning dew. Suddenly I start to think of the day that I first met her. A bucket of snow had landed in her hair. I picture her shaking snowflakes off her shoulders, and somehow I want to get us back to there. I want her to know that I can't bear to spend a single day without her, but how can she know? How can she know?
Shoot, ow, a shoe, a shoe, a shoe, damn, this is really fantastic, no, really absurd. And what, you just stand there and don't say a word? Take all day, fine, then bring it yourself, your cabernet, Jesus!
Shut up, Claire and Mary!
Fine! What?
We're going to have the dance troupe dance to the concert band, and they're doing an excerpt from Prokofiev's Peter and the Wolf. So please welcome members of the Shorecrest dance troupe and the Shorecrest concert band led by Mr. Ethan Updike.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
fast, and think of this in the KD.
Just a kiss, just a kiss, I have lived just for this. I can't explain why I've become Micheline. Just a smile. Just a smile, hold me captive, just a while. I can't explain why I've become Micheline. Every time your eyes meet Apple Bees. They fired me like
into a hotel. I said it's just as well, 'cause I don't want to be here. No, I don't want to be here. And I am not a negative person, so I packed up my bag, so I had no place to go. I opened a map and said, show me my future, 'cause it isn't where I am. I finally got a job at some humdrum office, like everyone right out of school does. I sat there at my cubicle every day, sending faxes, and that's what my life was. Oh, I went back home and said to my parents, I know what I'm going to do. And since I am a dork, I moved to New York. And I started grad school. I really don't want to be here.
Instead of being the curtain puller, I got to actually participate. But mainly, this is Mr. Ahlin and Miss Lee and Mr. Updike's show, and it was fantastic tonight, so congratulations. Okay, so last year we did Mary Poppins in the spring, and it ended up being one of the most gigantic shows we've ever done. It was really, really difficult. And we said, what we really need to do next year is an even bigger show that's even more difficult. And it actually was such a challenge that it took us 4 months of researching and considering and thinking and looking at budgets before we could even commit to saying, okay, we're gonna do it. Please come back this spring when we will be presenting Phantom of the Opera. Thank you.
All right, so here's our grand finale. Y'all go out and enjoy some art and go enjoy some snacks in the Student Activity Center, and hope you have a good time.
Yeah.